Soothing story time. The Yeti and the Strange Cave, Part 5. Well, the Yeti climbed out yet another hole in the ground, checked. There were still no paintings of Yetis chasing him. All there was the flickering torchlight dancing on the rough walls. He looked ahead, more flickering light. He really hoped this was going to be a nice room with food in it. He was really hungry now. He'd be happy to gnaw the moss off the stones, if there was any. Anything edible at all. He sniffed. The air was dry, with a hint of soot from the burning torches, those ahead and behind. The Yeti set off carefully to the next cave. When he got to the opening into the next cave, he peered around. There were flaming torches round the walls. There were no doors, but there was a spiral staircase that started at the edges of the cave. As it rose higher and higher, it curled towards the center of the cave. The spiral went up into the ceiling, but beyond that, the Yeti couldn't see. The Yeti had never seen a spiral staircase before. He loved the shape of it. So perfect and round, smooth steps that would never poke sharp edges into his black paws. He walked round it, touching the stone, trying to see what was past the ceiling, but he couldn't. He looked over at the nearest torch. Yetis didn't use fire. He reached out and quickly drew his hand away. He waited, then reached out his hand again. There was no breeze in here. The flame flickered gently. The Yeti reached out his hand. A tiny flame jumped from the torch to his hand and began to burn his fur merrily. The Yeti squealed and slapped the back of his hand again and again. The flame went out, leaving a little singed patch on the back of his hand. The Yeti ambled away from the flame, looking back at it to make sure it didn't try anything else. The flame burned quietly. He didn't trust the flame. Not in these caves. He turned away a little, watching it out of the corner of his eye. It burned quietly, so he turned his back and ambled over to the bottom step of the spiral staircase. When a tiny flame leapt out of the torch and landed in the center, the top of his head. the Yeti didn't feel it. He began to climb the stairs. These stairs were lovely to climb, so smooth beneath his feet. Pat, 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 up he went. The smell of the burning torches still tickled about in his nostrils, or so he thought. The tiny flame was enjoying itself, burning one strand of fur at a time on the Yeti's head. The lovely stairs curled round and round, up past the rocky ceiling, up where the light was faint, up away from the torches, but he could still see. It was as if he carried his own light with him. The spiral staircase cut up through rock, leaving smooth sides behind it. The Yeti reached out and ran his hand over the surface. The rocks by the river were like this, good to touch, good to stand and sit down on. The Yeti wondered if these had been made by water falling through the hole. But that wouldn't make the stairs. He stopped with his hand still on the smooth wall. Who on earth had made this? The rest of the cave had creatures living in it, but these were made. Yetis couldn't do this. They didn't know how. The Yeti looked up. All he could see was the underside of the spiral stairs. He'd like to meet whoever made this. He'd like to learn how to do it. Pat, pat, pat. He carried on up the stairs, with a pale light illuminating his way as the tiny flame burned another strand of hair. Pat, pat, pat. The light grew. The Yeti could see the shapes from dancing flames on the stairs above. Pat, 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 pat. There was an edge higher up. Peered over it. There were more spirals, more twisting rock, in a huge cavern. Rawr. Flaming torches lit up a spiral slide that went round the walls. It started at the high ceiling and round and round it went. Pat, pat, pat. The Yeti climbed up till he could see the whole cavern. The spiral staircase continued up into the rough rock ceiling. But so did two more spiral staircases. The Yeti ambled over to them to see. If they disappeared into the floor. But they didn't. They went only up into the ceiling. But at the top of one was another spiral slide that curved round all the spiral stairs and ended smoothly by joining the floor. Then the Yeti noticed the floor was smooth here too. Smooth slides, smooth stairs. rock beneath his feet. The tiny flame burned another hair on his head. The Yeti walked pat, 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 pat out into the huge cave. First, he walked round and round the room, touching the smooth sides. Then he climbed up the smooth spiral stairs and slid down the smooth rock, round and round the room, and slid out from the bottom slide and slid away across the smooth floor. Back up again he went, round and round the stairs, then round and round the room, again and again, until he felt dizzy and sat on the floor. When his head cleared, he got up and pat, pat, pat up the stairs again. He forgot his hunger. He didn't notice a tiny flame was making a small ball patch on the top of his head. He was having a great time. He hadn't played like this since he was a cub. A baby Yeti, a ball of fluff, born in spring, with the cutest little wet nose in the world. He'd rolled down the summer hills and got flowers stuck in his fur. He'd happily eaten them later. He got lost again and again, but he never minded. His parents were worried at first, but he was always happily playing in mud, asleep up a tree, eating berries, or chasing the scared ball creatures to try and make friends. In the end, his parents stopped worrying. He'd turn up somewhere, often brought back by a different Yeti who had found him napping under fruit bushes, with his tiny dark toes wriggling in his sleep. All the Yetis knew for hundreds of miles round to return the amiable ball of fluff. The Yeti himself never minded. He dozed off somewhere nice and woke up back with his parents. Then he'd go and roll down the nearest hill. From a distance, it looked like someone must be rolling a huge pom-pom down a slope for reasons of their own. Until the pom-pom got up and ambled back up the hill to roll down it again, which then stopped when he felt dizzy and ate anything he had picked up on his fur before climbing the hill and rolling again. So the Yeti went round and round, wishing he was picking up snacks on the way like he used to when he was small. The tiny flame on the Yeti's head had eaten enough hair now. When the Yeti slid down to the floor and ambled past the staircase that came up from the floor below, the tiny flame leapt off into the gap. The light floated down past the smooth walls and poof, landed on a step. It popped along the edge of the step and leapt forward, floating down again, illuminating the stone as it went. Down it went, till it reached the cave below. Poof, pop, 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 across the floor, and then leapt up to go home to its torch. The Yeti hadn't noticed a thing. He was whooshing round the slide. He didn't notice how long he stayed there. But after a while, he did notice a dripping sound. Every now and then, there was a drip. It came from one of the staircases that went up into the roof. He was feeling dizzy again, so he went to have a look until the dizziness wore off. A drip fell on his head halfway up the stairs. It landed on the bald patch the tiny flame had made. He felt his head. Confused, he felt all the way around. No more bald patches. Wow. He poked at the bald patch. Wow. Another drip landed on his hand. He looked up. Wow. He forgot about the bald patch. Up the stairs he went. He sniffed the air. It was damp here. Sniff, sniff, sniff. Was that moss? Sniff, sniff, sniff. Might be moss. Sniff, sniff, sniff. Moss. There was light up here. Ah, but it was green. Pat, pat, pat. Round he went until the stairs opened out to a cave. He poked his head up over the edge of the smooth wall. Rawr. The green room. Moss glistening and growing over every surface. He reached out his hand and touched the delicate spires. So soft and so delicious. He gnawed at the sparkling green plants that grew around the top of the wall. Even the top of the stairs had a soft green carpet. There was no way out of the room. It was a cave of velvet green, whose walls were as soft as the Yeti's fur. He gnawed around the edges of the opening into the cave, then levered up the succulent plants and enjoyed every mouthful. He cleared a path through the cave, exposing the bare, damp floor. When he was full, he sighed happily and curled up on the floor to sleep.